Strong Fight Night. This fight is brought to you by Buffalo Bills Western Store, Grow Strong MMA, Baguli Transport, Toza Farrier Service, and Nutramix. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, weighing in at 91.9 kilograms, training out of the Fight Club Bully Team, making his debut in the cage tonight, Bodie Dean. And standing across from him in the cage tonight, in the red corner, weighing in at 93.1 kilograms, training out of the Modern Warrior MMA gym, making his debut in the cage tonight as well, ladies and gentlemen, Fred Samoan Warrior, Tamalatoa!
Definitely a couple of big boys in the cage.
I'm just hoping it goes at least two rounds. I want to see some experience. I want to see some just some adversity. Let's go. Let's go, fellas.
Yeah, again, on paper, it seems to be a bit of a grappler versus a striker matchup, and that's only an educated guess with Fred coming from the Modern Warrior gym. And Brody, like I said, the only experience I've seen with him were in grappling competitions.
Ooh, Brody's trying to throw that.
He's collided.
Mm-hmm. Brody's trying to knock him out. He's almost, like almost got his back, though. Oh, no.
It's such a different world, Muay Thai to MMA. First round, you boys just come out banging. Like, you're like, I'm big, and I'm here to stamp my ground. Like, you know, for Muay Thai, I love first round, tip-tap, just suss out my opponent. You boys, you're like, oh, hell no, I ain't got time for that.
Well, I think experience-wise, I think once they get out there and have their first few fights and get past that, then the experienced ones coming in, and they start, you know, measuring themselves in the first couple of rounds. And then maybe the third round, they go hell-bent for leather.
Yeah, you're exactly right. You know, most of those professional MMA fighters, their game plan really starts in that second round, doesn't it?
Yes, definitely.
Nice little sprawl there.
Oh, he's going. Oh, he's got a little bit of a submission.
Bit of a bully choke going on. But
yeah, no, he got out of it.
Brody would have been in that position many a times before.
I was always in that position.
So wearing shin pads, so obviously this is a C-class fight, which means no strikes to the head of a grounded opponent.
And we talked about that last event. And again, remind you know the people that are listening, what improvements or what changes would you make?
It's a tricky one, isn't it? You know, I'm not a fan of C-class, but I see the place that it has.
Yes.
You know, right now, the natural progression is, or the natural instinct for Brody right now is to throw strikes to the head. He's watched probably 10, 15 years of mixed martial arts, and he's seen those strikes to the head. He's probably working into a position where he should be striking to the head. But then again, would he have taken this fight if they were allowed to throw those strikes? And it's probably no. So, yeah, we've taken away one aspect of the fight, but because of that, we were still able to get the last 80% of an MMA fight, which I'm happy with.
The other thing, I think maybe they should have a time limit. You know, maybe if nothing's happening in the first 35, 40 seconds, maybe standing back up, which is sort of normal for MMA anyway.
Yeah, that's right. I remember back in the day, there was a show called Combat 8. Yep. They had a minute. Once the fight hit the ground, you had a minute total
to
submit. That's right. Yep. Or if not, they stood the fight up. Brody reversing that position again. Fred looks like he's sinking in that guillotine. He's squeezing hard. 10 seconds to go. He just needs to hold on a couple more seconds. Oh, that was close to a tap, wasn't it?
Really tight.
He's holding on. Wow.
Whoa. I think he just barely made it. What's up, Reese? What do you think, man?
I think Brody. I'm pretty sure Brody's just using that experience from all his grappling comps as just being a nice, relaxed, chiller dude. And if it wasn't, and it was going to be a tap, I'm excited that it didn't get called, because now we finally see a second round for tonight.
Thank you.
And we can drag it out a bit better. So, and they reset from the start now. They're back to standing up. They're both big boys. They both like to bang.
Yeah. Problem with gassing your arms out. He's getting a little bit of a rest now. But then having to stand up and throw those hands again, sometimes you got a lot of blood in your arm. So they got to weigh that up as far as when they let go, when they apply more pressure. What do you reckon?
Yeah, absolutely. You can actually see it right now. You know, Brody Dean out there, his corners have got his hands raised, trying to get the blood back into his arms. You know, Fred, once again, he's got a really strong corner. You know, Felice, Lou Filiano in the corner as well. Unfortunately, Lou's had his opponent pull out 3 or 4 times this show, so we missed out on that opportunity. But
yeah. And he looks a little more fresh between the two fighters. He seems like he's taking his rest period a little bit more, and he's recovering. And we have Chris Hay, current, present fighter, and referee.
Yeah, well done him there too, noticing the water on the floor and on his back for the opponent. So, oh, yeah, wild punches.
Oh, feeling the sweat coming off.
Oh, desperate takedown there from pretty far out, but he's managed to possibly.
It looks like he's got a bit of a submission. Nah, he's going to pop out of that.
Tricky though, he had his arm trapped there for a little bit, but again, it'll be interesting to see if he can work his way into a submission here. But like I said, these C-class rules, it's going to be tough to open up any position here if he can't strike to the head.
And once that blood's flowing, once you're into that fight, to stand up is something, not something you would naturally think of because you're just going for leather. But I'm telling you, man, you should probably stand up, give him his chance. Now he's in the north-south. He should probably just stand up.
Not sure why. Oh, there we go. Just the mouth guard's
popped out. All
right,
dumps the mouth guard, yeah.
To the side, Sonny, to the side.
Not many submission attempts here. There might be a bit of a Kimura or something. Chance for a guillotine there. Bro, he looks like he's got that hand in. No, pops it out. Tell you what, that first round was pretty tough to score as well, wasn't it?
And that was on the ground. He gave him a, that wasn't a good strike. That was a penalty.
And they were two solid punches, weren't they?
Yes. Do you think they need to take a point, or is that just a warning?
Me personally, the rules meeting is actually before the fight. You know, so in terms of points and taking a point, me personally, I probably would. You know, he would have been sent his contract. He would have been told it was a C-class and no fights, no punches to the ground. And again, that would have been reminded to him. And I was there at the rules meeting, you know, where they actually said, yeah, no punches to the ground for C-class fighters. So there we go. Looks like he is taking that one punch and it is justified.
Yeah. Which sort of leads us back to what we were talking about recently, you know, maybe they shouldn't have the C-class. Maybe they should just go have the B-class and give all these fighters good instructions in the rules ceremony. What do you think?
Just comes down to how long. I think it's a bit of a natural reaction. Like you watch every
hand.
MMA event, it's always your opponent goes down, you chase him. You look for that finish.
Right.
And that's all the boys are doing. That's the culture of the sport. You clip him and then you chase him.
Yep.
And that's all he was doing there. But great work on Chris Hayes' behalf of, you know, calling it straight away and taking a point.
Yeah.
It's definitely something that needs to be reprimanded.
Yeah, he was right on top of that. I love that about him.
Yeah, I've been really impressed with the way that he's officiated. Like I said, he picked up the water, picked up the low blows.
Well, Chris is another bloke that's been around the sport for such a long time as well. Like, you know, he looks for these things all the time as well, so it's great to see.
Great submission defense there from Brody. He knew when he's in that guillotine, you always got to go to that opposite side of the choke.
And it's really good to see them this late in the second round that they're thinking about that kind of stuff. It's almost become instinctive.
Again, there was absolutely no malice in that those strikes to the ground from Brody, was it? It was strictly just a reaction, wasn't it?
Yeah.
It's just straight reaction. Like, you know, they're both getting up off the ground. They're in a fight, and he's chasing him.
Yeah.
Like, natural reaction. Get away from me, or we're going to bang. And if you keep coming forward, this is what's happening. He keeps on the touch.
Fred looks to be looking for that guillotine as
well. Yeah, I think he's going to try to secure the takedown right before the end of the round. Oh, he almost got it. He got it reversed on him. Great round by both.
Both boys, no one seems to be slowing up yet, do they?
Well, I'll tell you what. We've even come to a third round. So what do you think the strategy should be coming into the third round?
It's a tough one, isn't it? Like, both boys haven't really been too close to a submission in that last round. And you'd have to think that, especially with Fred's go-to move being that guillotine deep into that third round.
Yep.
Not sure if he's got the gas left in that arm or not to pull one off.
I'd love to be hearing what they're saying to Fred in that corner. The thing that I see is he has a little bit more conditioning about himself. So, like, I know, Reese, you're watching this, and you've been a great corner. What would you be saying to either one of these fighters?
If I'm in Fred's corner, I'm telling him to stay on his feet because Brody's looking for the takedown. He wants to take it to the ground. That's his strong point. I'd be telling Fred to stay light on his toes and just flick to the body, whether even if it's just a slow jab. Brody's walking forward. He's going to walk onto it. It's going to catch him in the breadbasket. It's going in the third. They're both getting tired. As for Brody, I'd be telling him, at the start when he walked out, he was cutting angles, he was moving. Use his angles, take from the side, and shoot for his takedown that way.
Awesome.
He's got the energy there. You can tell it. He's good to go. It's just, now it's just that grinding. They've got to grind it out. And who wants to grind harder? Like,
that's
this is the point where who wants to take it home is going to take it home now.
All right, decision, knockout, or are we going with submission? What's happening this third round?
I think we're going decision, and I've got no idea which way it's going to go.
I think it's going to go submission for some reason. I think Fred's going to get him with a guillotine.
Whoa, nice shot over the top.
Oh. Can I change that? Can I change that to a TKO?
Again, and it really comes down to that experience. Having the benefit of being able to go to the ground and not cop those strikes. If you are in trouble, you can take a knee. You know, so I wonder if Sebastian Kostov in Brody's corner is giving him that way out.
I think they would love to have your brain right now. They should have that instinct to be able to think like that. But those are good suggestions. Fantastic.
Man, I think the only thing they're thinking is get oxygen into my body.
Yeah, exactly. I was noticing both boys between rounds. Brody Dean probably looked the little bit fresher. You know, Fred was gassed a little bit more. But again, you never know if he's just playing that up to his opponent or not.
I don't think either one of them playing. They're exhausted right now. Look at them. This is where you don't even know where you're at right now. You just know you're in a fight.
Tough to score. It literally could come down to this round. You know, we don't know how that first round went. Very close. Possibly. Flip of a coin, you might have given it to Fred, possibly.
Yep. And then that second round, it was just back and forth. You just never know how the refs are going to score any round.
Yeah,
never leave
right.
It to the judges, right? So
I just go back to Paul Briggs, Nathan Briggs' motto of when in doubt, knock him out. Like, let's just stand and bang.
That's it.
And that's coming from a dude that's like, I'm the runt of the litter. I'm always the small guy.
Yeah, that's it. But it doesn't matter. The chin's only so big. Fred's sort of taking over this round. He's sort of establishing himself. If he just keeps going, that's right. He's making a smart move. Well done, young man.
And he's definitely landed the biggest strikes in this round.
He loves that overhand right. He's been having a lot of success with it.
I don't know about you, Mikey, but I grew up in Logan, and that's where Modern Warrior is based out of.
Yep.
And there is a lot of island boys. And when you come sparring, you just keep that left hand up high on top of your head because
yep.
that overhand is coming.
Yes, yes, they love it. I hear you.
It's like a natural born instinct. Like, and they throw it, and it comes down like Thor's hammer. Like, it's heavy, it's weighted, and it hurts.
And it's quick. It's a quick reaction all the time.
Yeah.
Wow, he lands those punches.
Whoa.
Brody grimacing as those punches come through.
Yeah, he definitely does not like them punches.
Looks like he might get his back here if he can move to it.
4 ounce gloves with that kind of power behind it, you feel everything.
15 seconds to go on the round. Brody's definitely got to act quickly if he wants to try and sink that choke in. 10 seconds, I think he might be running out of time here.
Yeah, I'm going to go, if I'm a bet man, I'm thinking Fred's won this match.
Yeah, it might be a 29-27 possibly.
Yep.
But like I said, yeah, definitely going to be tough to call that one.
Great fight. Great fight. Great effort by both. Well done, gentlemen.
So, Reese, when you see a couple of big boys like that winning it, 93 kilos, are you kind of glad that you fought at around 70, 77 yourself?
Oh, 100%. There was a late minute pull out last night and I contemplated it and then I thought, no, I've got to go to work on Monday. But yeah, you can hear the leather cracking. It's it's definitely going to tickle in the morning.
As we can see, the judges making their way around, getting the calculators out. So you'd have to think that one point that was taken off Fred is playing with this result here.
It's definitely a job I'm glad I don't have. I'm much happier to sit here and talk.
Yeah.
But both boys obviously put in a very hard training camp to come in, go the three rounds, and drag it out a bit better.
Ladies and gentlemen, after the full three rounds, what a cracker. After three rounds of frantic fighting, we have a majority decision. And the winner, Fred Samoan Warrior Tamalotoa.